Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're going to solve quadratic equations, but we're going to use inverse operations. Now, so far we've solved quadratics using factorising. All I want you to do is pause the video, and for these five different questions here, I want you to just talk through what you would do to solve these. I'll give you a little tip, they all involve factorising. Okay. In this case here, we've dealt with this. There was no number term here. And you would have just factorized out the x, and that would have helped you solve the answer. One of them would be x is 4, one of them would be x is negative 4. Here, there is a number term here, and you're looking for two numbers that multiply to negative 12 and add to 4. Step 1, you would have factorized as follows, and then you would have henceforth solved, getting you x is negative 6 and x is positive 2. This quadratic wasn't equal 0, and you know you can only solve quadratics when they're equal to 0. So you would have subtracted 12 off both sides to make the right hand side equaling 0, and oh look, you'd have the equation above which you can solve. The one below, you're supposed to spot those and think to yourself, they're a difference of two squares. That is basically x squared subtract 12 squared, which I know factorises to x subtract 12, x add 12 is 0. And I factorise that, and therefore I get x is positive 12 and x is negative 12. The last one, again, you would try and factorise. Unfortunately, it's not an easy factorise. You have to factorise by grouping. Okay, so you'd go off and factorise that by grouping. And when you've done that, you would have got the following answer here. You would have got that. And that would have then given you x is negative 3 over 2 and x is negative 1. Okay, that's what we've done so far. There's one last case I need to show you about. In fact, it's easier than all these cases I've shown you here. But sometimes when students see it, they're so into factorising mode to solve quadratics that they just forget that it's actually easier than that. So I'm going to go straight into these easy examples where we can use what's called inverse operations. Imagine someone told you to solve x squared is equal to 100. Pause the video and tell me what x is. Okay, well, let's think about what happened to x on its journey. You had x and you squared it and you got x squared. And it gave you the answer 100. So what's the opposite of squaring something? Well, it's to square root something. So if I take the square roots here, I would get x's, and this is the trick that people sometimes forget, positive or negative the square root of 100. So the square root of 100 is 10, so one answer is x is positive 10, on the other answer x is negative 10. Now just take a second there, make sure that makes sense to you. You know it has to have a positive and negative answer, because we know a positive times a positive, positive 10 times positive 10 gives me positive 100, but also negative 10 multiplied by negative 10 gives me a positive 100. So go back and look at your square and square root videos in the number strand if this isn't making sense. Now just while we're here, I just want to actually sneakily show you. Now I don't want you to do it this way necessarily. I could actually solve that by factorizing, because I could make one side 0. I could subtract 100 off both sides, okay, to make the right hand side is equal to 0, and look what I'd get. I'd get myself x squared subtract 100 is equal to 0. Now 100 is 10 squared. So this is x squared subtract 10 squared is equal to 0, which I can solve by the difference of two squares. X subtract 10, x add 10 is 0, and therefore x is negative 10 or x is positive 10, the same as I found above. So there were two ways of solving it, by inverse operations, and actually you could have used the difference of two squares in this case. Now, I think these are so easy, you might as well just use inverse operations, but I just want to show you it's interesting that the other technique still works in this case. Let's try another one. Pause the video and see if you can do that yourself. I'll be honest with you, I think inverse operations are the easiest, so I'll show you that way first. Think what happened to x. You took x, you squared it, and then you got x squared. Then you multiplied by 4, and you got 4x squared. The squaring happens before the multiplication by 4. That gave you the answer 100. So let's just think what we have to do to undo this series of operations. The opposite of multiplying by 4 is dividing by 4, and I'd get myself 25. And then the opposite of squaring is square rooting, and I'd get myself positive or negative 5. When I take the square root of 25, I get positive or negative 5. Let's just show that with algebra. I would look at that and I'd say the first thing I'm going to do is undo the multiply by 4, and that's going to get me x squared is equal to 25, and then I'm going to take square roots of both sides, knowing I'm going to get positive or negative the square root of 25, so x is 5 or x is equal to negative 5. Just quickly, why don't I show you that you can also do this by difference of two squares? If I subtracted 100 from both sides, I get 4x squared subtract 100 is equal to 0. This is 2x all squared. Take away this is 10 squared is equal to 0. And that factorizes by a difference of two squares as 2x subtract 10, 2x add 10 is equal to 0. Solving that, you would get x is 5 or x is negative 5, just as above. Now, in future, I'm not going to show difference of two squares anymore. I'm just going to use inverse operations because they're easier. And also, sometimes this gets messy when the numbers aren't as nice as 4 and 100. So henceforth, I'll just do that. But look, we did get the same answer, so it's useful practice. Pause the video, have a go. Think what happened here. I want to undo the multiplied by 7. So I'm going to divide both sides by 7 and I'm going to get myself x squared is equal to. Let me go over here and do 448 divided by 7 by short division. 7 into 4 goes no times, carry the 4. 7 into 44 goes 6 times, carry the 2. 7 into 28 goes 4 times. This must be 64. To find x, I take square root. So x is going to be, and I always get a positive and negative answer, positive or negative the square root of 64. So x on the one hand would be negative 8, or x on the other hand would be positive 8, and we're done. Next one, pause the video, have a go. Okay, I'm going to undo that multiply by 4, so I'm going to divide both sides by 4, and I get myself x squared is therefore 9 over 4. Now I'm going to take the square root of both sides to get x's, I get a positive and negative answer, the square root of 9 over 4. Now using our Surd's laws, we know this is positive or negative. We can work that out as root 9 over root 4. And we know the square root of 9 is 3. And we know the square root of 4 is 2. So this is positive or negative 3 over 2. So the two answers for x, x is either the positive 3 over 2 or x is equal to negative 3 over 2. We're done. Next one. Pause the video and have a go at this. This time leave your answers as simplified surds. Okay, so let me just write that out. 2x squared is equal to 24. I'm going to undo that multiply by 2 by dividing both sides by 2. And I'm going to get myself that x squared is therefore equal to 12. Taking square roots, I get x is therefore equal to positive or negative root 12. I'm not allowed to stop there because remember I always have to simplify a surd. So to simplify this, I'm going to write it as a square number. I'm going to think of what square number goes into 12. And I know that's 4 multiplied by 3. 4 is the biggest square that goes into 12. So this is going to be positive or negative root 4 root 3. So this is going to be positive or negative root 4 is 2, so 2 root 3. So let me state my answers. X is either 2 root 3, positive 2 root 3 that is, or x is negative 2 root 3. And we're done. Last one for you to try. Pause and have a go. So I've got myself 3x squared is equal to 60. I'm going to divide both sides by 3 to undo that multiplied by 3. And I'm going to get myself x squared is equal to 20. I'm going to take square roots. X is therefore positive or negative square root 20. I should simplify root 20. Why didn't I do it over here? That's going to be 20 can be written as 4 multiplied by 5. So this is going to be root 4 root 5. So this is going to be 2 root 5. So therefore x on the one hand is positive 2 root 5, and x on the other hand is going to be negative 2 root 5. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.